stock from Oak Ridge, Tennessee, Greg Martin, and assisting him from Knoxville, Tennessee, Aaron Gibson. Yours truly, the voice of the Have a Tampa Dirt Late Models from Maryville, Tennessee. I'm Roby Helm, and it's our pleasure to bring you America's favorite show on. Getting set to get down to it. Our first 12-lap Boyle Upper Fools heat race. Dwayne Hobble and Earl Pearson Jr. will bring them up before turn two. The college race. Everything looks good. We'll go green when they get back to the cone on the front straightaway. Rick Eckert on the point. Dale McDowell second. David Payne in third. Dwayne Hobble fourth. Francis in fifth. Derek Cougar in the sixth spot. Car has lost a drive shaft signal. Drivers on the outside looking in the seventh spot. Earl Pearson Jr. in car number one. Bill Reed in the eighth position. And ninth is Dwayne Kiefer in car number 21K. The 25 of Derek Coogan. So UDTRA officials going right to Dwayne Hobble's car for the bumping incident after the checkered flag came out. So we will have to wait to see if UDTRA officials will be handing out a penalty to Dwayne Hobble that could knock him out of the... So Dwayne Hobble getting an earful from... Getting the one to go signal. If UDTRA officials like what they see, will go green when they get back to the cone. Scott Lindquist and Skip Harp. Bring them off the fourth turn. Skip Harp on the outside. Grandstanding. Lindquist in second. Duke and Mars, they see the lead in the end for third. Clifford Bramson. Drivers on the outside looking in at group of seventh place car. Jeff Bunger in the 03 car. Randy Weaver running eighth in the 116. Ninth is Charles Hurst in car number 1H. Tenth is H.E. Vineyard in car number 24. And Vineyard going to let Moran go in front of him for the restart. Spins the Hurst Electric. Weeks Camaro over. Driver looking for that inside to come in. Patrick Dugan running third in car number 15. Jimmy Mars holding down the fourth spot in the 20AM automobile. Dusty Christenberry in the C3 car in fifth. And the CV3 car of Clayton Christenberry in the sixth and final transfer spot. Field getting set to go back to green flag action. Seven laps down, five to go. Skip Harp brings it down. In the fifth spot in the sixth and final transfer spot. With the win, our second Borla Performance Heat Racing car number 31 out of Georgetown, Tennessee in the Curtis Equipment GRT Monte Carlo. He'll start the main event tonight from the outside of the front row. How about a nice round of applause for Skip Harp? Coming home in the second spot in the Zero automobile from Mooresburg, Tennessee. He'll line up for the main event with Dan Sleeper on the outside. Ray Cook on the inside of the second row with Ronnie Johnson alongside him in the 5J. Freddie Smith on the inside of row three. Tommy Devaney alongside of him in car number 20. Here they come off the fourth turn. Scott Sexton, Dan Sleeper bring them down. We're going to Johnson, your sixth place finisher in the 5J. So coming home with the win in heat race number three, he'll line up on the inside of the second row for the main event in the Kristen Berry Trucking and Farms GRT Monte Carlo. Your 1996 Alabama Tampa National Champion. How about a nice round of applause for the Southern gentleman, Freddie Smith. Everything looks good. We'll go green for the count on the front straightaway. Earl Pearson Jr. on the third position. Randy Weaver alongside Tommy Delaney on the inside of row two. Left side of him, Bill Reed in car number 28. Jeff Munger and David Crabtree in the third row. Top four go on to the big show. Here they come, rolling off the fourth turn to the starting point. everybody up on your feet. Stand up and wave to the drivers. They'll be waving at you as they say thank you for your support of the Have a Tampa Dirt Late Models and Dirt Late Model Racing in general. Ladies and gentlemen, wave at them, the cars and stars of the Have a Tampa Dirt Late Models. 26 of the top dirt late model drivers in the country saluting you, the world's greatest race fans. One of the most beautiful sights in all of motorsports, the four-wide salute to the fans. Everybody on the back straightaway, up on your feet in the pit grandstand. Everybody up in the beer garden, wave at them. They're waving at you. So now the ceremonies have been completed. The field will now pull into their one last look, just to make sure they're reading where they should be. Tugging down on those shoulder horses one last time, getting comfortable in the race car, because now it is time to get down to the business at hand. The signal going to the drivers with the full green flag. If everything looks good, we'll go up over in turn number three. Rick Eckert and Skip Arc bring them around to turn number four. Now they can see the cone. Here they come. The green flag. Those two drivers have pulled away from a torrid battle for third. Right now, Freddie Smith in the third spot in the double zero automobile as getting the field lined up the way they were running. 5-2. Your race leader at car number 31 with Dale McDowell in second, Freddie Smith in third. Skip Hart looking for his first win of the 2000 season. And that would be his first win since 1998 for Georgetown, Tennessee driver. Dale McDowell looking for his third win of the season in the 17M car. Freddie Smith moved from the point standing, still looking for his first win of the year. Scott Lundquist in fourth, but out of Tampa home leader, he don't get the best. He has been through the winner's circle twice this season. The 12th starting spot up to second. Here they come. Cars up to speed, and when that happens, hopefully that'll lift some of the fog out of the air. There's a little bit better visibility as the fog rolling in to Atomic Motor Speedway. But Skip Arp has so many laps around this speedway, he could probably drive around here blindfolded in that 31 car. A Dan Streeper, the man on the move, the man to watch. He's cleared the scales, and here he comes, ladies and gentlemen, Dan Streeper, your winner. Getting a big hug from his brother and engine builder, Bill Streeper with Pro Power Engines. Dan, step up here.
I told you twice, I had a heat race. We fired off real good and quit on us at the end. I knew I had a good car, it was just a matter of being able to get through the traffic. Track suited my needs tonight, too.
Boy, it certainly did. What a show. You got up on the outside in Dan Streeper fashion, just inches away from the wall, and it looked like that it just opened up for you. You had clear sailing and were just driving by people like they were parked. That's got to be an awesome feeling.
I think everybody was kind of gun-shy because the bottom was so good in the heat races. Everybody kind of was figuring the bottom would be good. I got up top, started rolling up there, and it felt pretty good. So more people started going down. I went up and went around.
Well, Dan, we see the fog rolling in here to Atomic Motor Speedway. Was visibility a problem out there tonight?
No, actually, I got those, tear-offs there, racing optics, one down there at the Texas race. I put on about 21 of them, where normally you can't run that many, but I just got to thank my brother, Bill Streeper. My motor just ran awesome, right? Former tripping, Uncle Buck, never can do it without him. And Josie, Rich, Dan, and everybody other than, Jim Page and Jake, Fitzmotors and Sandy, I love you guys all. Thanks.
I know that your fourth win of the season, and I was around for the other three, and I know we're going to be right back here tomorrow night. So I think that you probably got a big party planned to celebrate this in the pit area tonight.
We didn't have anything planned yet, but I'm sure we'd come up with something.
Dan, congratulations. Great job tonight. Let's give him another nice round of applause. Dan Sleeper, your winner tonight from the 12th starting position to first.